Okay, so what I'm going to do is just have a quick chat about how I approach my painting using the sketches. So when I'm in the studio and I want to get a painting going, what I usually do is I'll say, okay, I was out down by the river yesterday and I'd really like to do a painting based on the sketches that I did there. So I've got these ones. So that collage was quite nice. I quite like that one. It's got some nice reflective bits in it, and the contrast was really good yesterday because it was really sunny, so that was good. So it's those elements. So I've been saying to you about trying to focus on something quite simple when you're sketching, trying to have a simple idea. What I'm going to do then is pretty much using the same same colours initially that I was using while I was out sketching, just trying to get it going in a fairly monochromatic way, really, just to try and get the painting going. Okay. I'm just trying to get some of these marks going in a similar sort of way to the sketch. I wonder what this colour is.
Is that Payne's Grey
It was a bit of Payne's Grey, but then some black. Yeah, I just wanted a little bit of colour. This is it's like a water soluble. Yeah, I think it's those inky ones, I can't remember what they're called.
Intense.
Yeah, that's it. I think it's black, actually. I think it might be sort of dark. No, it's sort of nice one. Just looking at some of these marks, really. Right at the beginning, a painting like this, I really just want to start getting some marks and colours and shapes going.
So how many of these marks show at the end? Go over oil, probably not, so you don't have to.
Very
be too
few. Well, very few, probably. Yeah.
Very few. Yeah.
I think that.
So it doesn't actually matter what colour you've got, if it's not quite the right
colour. Well, I think what happens is that various parts of the painting tend to have different sort of levels of surface on them as they get worked into. And what I often do is I'll lose bits of the painting and then work over it, and then I'll bring them back. So it kind of goes backwards and forwards. And you get this building out, it's just some blue.
It's
like being playtime. I know. Yeah, but it should be playtime, shouldn't it? It should be fun, shouldn't it? So again, I'm using sort of different consistencies of paint as well, which is quite nice. Some of it's a bit stiffer, some of it's a bit looser.
Yes.
Getting lost underneath. And obviously just trying to keep it really loose and open. Hardly even really thinking much about the composition at this point, you know. Because I just want to get it interesting, but I'm not mushing everything together, so it's still, even though there's quite a lot happening on the surface, it's trying to keep it quite clean in a way. Yeah, I just want to put something down this bottom bit down here. I just want something that isn't this white.
No.
That's just a sparkly. It's quite sparkly, wasn't it? I think, you know, you've got those little slightly poetic ideas in your head when you're painting. It's quite nice. You know, what was it like? It was contrasty and sparkly. And those are quite nice things to have in your head while you're working. It's quite nice sometimes to do a series of paintings based on the same idea. So you can work through. So sometimes you get to a point where you go, oh, I quite like this, but I don't know where to go with it next. So you can pick up another painting and work through the same sort of image, the same subject, and maybe you'll find a way into your first painting by doing another one.
Mm-hmm.
So if you've got sort of two or three on the go of a similar subject, then you can kind of work them backwards and forwards across each other. Lighter marks in there as well, those darker areas. Do some work a little bit again in a minute as well. And you see it's got a bit. It's better when it was dry, wasn't it? I mean, really, these sorts of stage, I'm just trying to find things to work, work around in a way with the paint. So I'm just kind of, you know, I'm talking to some of you about keeping the composition really loose and working into negative spaces. So it's quite nice to just kind of randomly almost put some marks in, and then you, as you go on through the painting, you can kind of work into these sort of negative spaces that you kind of create as you go along. And in that way, you kind of build up a quite sort of organic type composition, really, and not be too not get too bound up with the sketches that you're working from, but just kind of using those as an inspiration for the paintings that you do in the studio. And I'm kind of working all the way down here because I just like to tie the bits of painting together, really. I'm not quite sure if I'll keep all that, but put it in anyway to see what happens. And it's a bit there, I quite like that shape there. Although it's a bit darker in the sketch, it's the shape, I quite like that shape just being there at the top of the painting, so I'll just put that in for now. I think sometimes you just spot something in a sketch and just put it down. It doesn't necessarily mean it's going to stay there forever. I think with this kind of painting, you just have to keep kind of chiselling away at it, really, and just keep doing things which you think are interesting at the time, and then hopefully, at some point, you get there.
Yeah.
It's just that sort of painting, really. Quite nice to not have it completely. I don't want it to be too black. Well, it's good working on paints, you know, once it's dry, you know, or dry enough, certainly, so that when I'm putting the brush marks on, it's not picking up what's underneath.
Mm.
So it means I can build up layers of paint rather than every time I put the brush on it, kind of just everything gets mushed together and goes all muddy. You know, this way you can kind of keep each layer quite fresh. So what I usually do is I work one layer, can be quite dark, and then the next layer can go back and bring some of the lightness back and just sort of go backwards and forwards between them. That's not too bad. It might be. What? Foolish, some might say. So just the white, that white paint underneath is quite dry. Yeah, I mean, I put a bit of Prussian blue in with it as well.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, to make it a bit bluer. I didn't want it to be too too grey. Yeah, it's one of those colours that does vary a lot.
Yeah, that's true.
What?
It's like Garam
Masala. Well, it's different no matter wherever you buy it from. It's different. Yeah.
Yeah.
If you've got that dry, textury brush mark stuff underneath. As long as it's nice and dry, it can be quite aggressive with the stuff that goes over the top, and then just work that through it. Better if they were dark green. Let's just put them in dark for now and see how they feel about it. I quite like going, you know, going backwards and forwards between different sketches. And like I've been saying to some of you about keeping the composition really open, you know, so if you switch between sketches, stops you just repeating yourself all the time on the same painting. You might go back to the original sketch that you started with later on, but by which time you've got lots of interesting things happening all over the painting, not just in the places that were in the sketch. Funky those marks, but it doesn't really matter because what I could do is work around those marks there. So I've been talking to you about this, finding these, doing random stuff and then finding the negative spaces, like these spaces in between these shapes, and pull those out. Again, the nice thing about this is that we, you know, I can work over this again. Just bring back the lightness. I felt that some of that got a bit kind of murky, so let's bring back some of the lightness, and I can work back into it again later on. Nice big, you know, mixture of marks. Some of it fiddly, some of it big and bold, and that mixture of things just keeps the whole thing moving. That's quite nice. That's quite nice. Mm-hmm. I'm going to do another one of those.
Looks just like a torn
paper. I think a lot of the time you're trying to find ways of recreating the sorts of marks that you get in the collages. When we were sketching, we were trying to find a mark that sort of stands in for what's there. And I suppose when I'm doing this, it's a similar sort of thing. I'm trying to find a painted mark that has a similar feel to the drawn marks and the collage marks. It's that, trying to get the painting to have the same sort of feel about it. I didn't like that bit there. Something about it just went really weird. I'm going to leave it here and have some lunch. So it's a bit branchy. But when that dries, I can work around those bits again. These are the sort of nice random things that happen. And then you can kind of do them more deliberately next time. I've done them by accident. And they've got a sort of nice natural feel to that. That's probably the best bit of the painting. That bit there, that last little bit that I did just before we finished. You know, did all that, and oh yeah, we cut all the time. And then,
because it was a bit
that's moving, you know.
Yeah. Let's load it.
Yeah.